distressing.
Yes, mother.
They disobeyed our customs.
Yes, mother.
Bring them in.
Are you of the same blood as Shi Qin?
Yes.
How so?
The aunt of my father's father has such blood.
It is the wish of my mother, Empress of all China, that you be set free.
I worship your generosity, Majesty, as do my companions.
No, they are not of your blood.
Your Majesty...
I regret to say, they must lose their heads.
Then I too must die.
Wait a moment. If you please. I am responsible. If anyone is going to die, let it be me.
This gentleman is my guardian. I would not wish to live without him.
Your guardian will be set free. He must die.
Die? Die?
No, it was my fault. I am the one responsible for putting us here. If someone is going to die, then it must be me.
But he's your guardian.
Yes.
It's a great puzzle. You may live. Rise.
Thank you, Your Highness.
This communique, sir, says, Mr. Phileas Fogg, accompanied by a young Indian woman, left the city of Hong Kong on approximately the 24th of this month. Now, we have that confirmed, sir. The man's alive.
We have here a man of such infinite cunning. He will surely become a case history in the annals of crime.
Without question, sir.
Fortunately, we still have one good prospect.
Yes, sir.
That remarkable Detective Hicks.
Oh, Fix, sir. Oh, he's staying very close to Fogg, sir, waiting for exactly the right moment to arrest him.
Quite so. This point of time, every hope, every expectation we have left lies in this one man, Detective...
Hicks, sir. Fix.
Damn fine fellow, Fix. Oh!
Afternoon. Afternoon.
I am so so very embarrassed.
Embarrassed?
For the lie I told His Majesty.
I wasn't aware that...
I mean in saying that you were my guardian.
Under the conditions, it was quite understandable. Indeed, you saved our lives. If I may say so, you were quite remarkable.
Oh, but I do not want you to feel that you must be responsible for me.
We are simply two people who have met under extenuating circumstances and will, of course, eventually go our separate ways.
Yes.
What was that?
If you will excuse me.
Oh, there you are, Mayor. You find me somewhat embarrassed, Mr. Fogg.
Oh, you too.
I feel impelled to make a statement.
Well,
I don't think you're going to quarrel with anything I'm going to say. I mean, a man, any man, you know, who claims to be a man, well, he's got to do his duty, hasn't he, sir?
I'm sorry, I don't quite follow.
Don't follow? No, it's just the other way around, isn't it, sir? I mean, that is the point. Follow.
Mr. Fix, have you been drinking?
No. Oh, no. Wouldn't touch the stuff. Not unless it was in the line of duty. Duty. That is what we're talking about, isn't it?
Is it?
Anything that happens, I don't want you to take it personally, sir. I want you to bear that in the forefront of your mind. I mean, don't take it personally. Well, at least I've got that off my chest. Good night, old man.
Jean, we were told that he arrived in Yokohama on the Carnatic.
What can I say, monsieur? The French consulate don't keep record of every Frenchman who comes to Yokohama.
But he just arrived yesterday and we...
Nevertheless, we're going to try to investigate. But before, I would like you to fill those forms, please.
Forms?
Yes, in triplicate. Sign each one of them.
Three copies.
Is that what I say?
Why?
You wish to discuss our policy, or do you wish to find your friend?
I assume that both would be asking too much.
Monsieur, allow me to introduce myself. I am Jean Passepartout, once renowned of the famous Cirque de Paris.
I am busy. What do you want?
To work, monsieur. You are looking at a true professional.
Are you strong?
Look at this. I once did a triple somersault on the high wire.
Can you sing?
Like a bird.
Can you sing standing on your head?
Many times. I do it for enjoyment.
Can you sing on your head with the top spinning on your left foot?
I like it best that way.
And with a saber balanced on your right?
A saber?
A saber.
You mean a sharp saber?
On both sides, sharp.
Well, why not?
The famous Lord!